Okay, so here we are. We're dealing with this subject of this word, this phrase called "Ye are gods" in Psalms 82 and in John 10:34. Now, my first two vids on the series, I covered Psalms 82. Now we're going to look at John 10:34. And here at the top it says, Jesus answered them, "Is it not written in your law, I said, ye are gods?" So a proper translation should be, Yeshua answered them, "Is it not written in your law, ye are magistrates and judges?" Now why is he telling them this? Let's pop up to verse 28, and he's having a little discussion with them. If we can get this thing to line up right, there we go. So here we are. Just start verse 28. He starts talking at the beginning of the chapter about how he's the door, and his sheep hear his voice, and this and that. And when he gets onto this phrase, he says, "And I give unto them eternal life, and they shall never perish, neither shall any man pluck them out of my hand. My Father, who gave them me, is greater than all. And no man is able to pluck them out of my Father's hand. I and my Father are one." In other words, Yeshua is telling him, "I am the Most High in a man's body." And when Yeshua told him that, verse 31, "And the Jews took up stones again to stone him." Now, why did they want to pick up stones? Why did they pick up stones to want to stone him? Because that was the law of Moses. They're accusing Yeshua of blasphemy. They're accusing this man in front of them, who they think is just a man, calling himself the Most High. "I'm the Most High. I'm like the Most High. I'm the Most High in a man's body." They're all, "Blasphemy! The law of Moses says you must be stoned. Blasphemy!" That's why they picked up the stones. Now, who were these people that picked up the stones? They were the leaders, the Pharisees, the Sadducees, the scribes, the lawyers, the judges, the magistrates, the ruling elite in Israel that oversaw and enforced the law of Moses that was the law of the land on the people. So anyway, let's read more on it. And then we're going to go into the Old Testament, and we're going to see the law of Moses spoken about this. And we'll look into some Hebrew and Greek words on it. And so he says, verse 32, "And Yeshua answered them, Many good works have I showed unto you from my Father. For what of these good works do you stone me?" Okay. "According to your law, O you judges and magistrates, you." And verse 33, "The Jews answered him, saying, For a good work we stone thee not, but for blasphemy, and because that thou being a man makest thyself the Most High." Blasphemy! How dare you, Yeshua, or how dare you, Jesus? And Jesus and Yeshua answered them, is it not written in your law? I said, ye are gods. Now he's talking about their law. And of course, Psalms 82 talks about this too. So it should be, it should say, Yeshua answered them, is it not written in your law? I said, ye are judges and magistrates. If he called them judges and magistrates, verse 35, or the word here is gods. If he called them judges and magistrates unto whom the word of the Most High came, what word is he talking about? The law of Moses. The law of Moses was given to the people, and they voluntarily put themselves under it to obey it. They shouldn't have done it, but they did it anyway. So now they're bound to it, and it's their law of the land. The word came to them through Moses. If he called them judges and magistrates unto whom the word of the Most High came, and the scripture cannot be broken, say ye of him whom the Father has sanctified. Now he's talking about himself. Say he of him whom the Father has sanctified and sent into the world, thou blasphemest. Thou blasphemest. He's telling them, you're the ones that are the blasphemers. You guys think you're obeying the law of Moses perfectly, and you're not. And not only that, you aren't even being good, just judges and magistrates. Not only are you being wicked to all the people and oppressing the poor and the needy, not only are you doing that and holding the law over them, not only are you doing that, this is considered blasphemy for you. Because you think you're being like the Most High. So he says, say ye of him whom the Father has sanctified and sent into the world. Oh, wait, okay. Sorry. Thou blasphemest. So he is quoting them. So scratch the last. Even though it is the truth. But say ye of him whom the Father has sanctified and sent into the world, thou blasphemest. So he's just quoting them. Because I said I am the Son of the Most High. 37. Then he goes on and on and on. But anyway, now let's look at some other stuff. Okay. Here's Ezra chapter 7, verse 25. And let's read what Ezra says. This is Ezra talking about the law of Moses. And thou, Ezra, after the wisdom of thy Creator, Jehovah, that is in thine hand, set magistrates and judges that may judge all the people that are beyond the river, all such as know the laws of thy Creator Jehovah, and teach ye them that know them not. So this gives us a little bit of perspective when, let's go back to, John 10, where he says, in verse 34 right here, Yeshua answered them, "Is it not written in your law, I said ye are magistrates and judges?" Now, let's go back to this other now what we're dealing here is dealing here with this little word here, gods. The Illuminati put this in here because they believe that they call themselves gods, because Satan brainwashed and trained them to think in such a manner. That's why they put this word in the Bible. That's why we see it scattered throughout the whole Bible. So, anyway. So here's this. All right, here. Let's stretch this out a bit. Let's put me over here a little bit more. And see if we can. I'm looking for the side over here. Okay. So let's go to Psalms 82 on the side over here. Scroll to Psalms. I'll put these links for all this Bible searching stuff in the description underneath. Okay, here's Psalms 82. So let's scoot it over. So here we are. Verse 6. I have said, ye are gods, judges and magistrates. Watch the first two vids and you'll see that the emphasis and the context of the whole psalm is about the judges and magistrates that were judging the people unfairly. And if you read the whole psalm for yourself, you'll be able to see that. So, let's click on this little word here, gods. Flashes in red when I put my pointer on it. Gods. Okay, here down at the bottom, see it says number 430 is the Strong's number. That's the concordance number. Here it is. Elohim is the word. Now let's read. Plural of Elohah. Gods in the ordinary sense, but specifically used in the plural. Thus, in the plural, it's Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Okay, in the plural, thus, especially with the article of the Supreme Creator. There's that word God there again. So we have to use context of what word to replace these Illuminati Freemason words they put in here. But all in all, the scripture is still intact for a man that is taught properly of how to piece it together and find the errors and correct them. Occasionally applied by way of deference to magistrates. Looky here. Do we see something here? Occasionally applied by way of deference to magistrates. And sometimes as a superlative, angels, ex exceeding,